Hi, I'm Tara Hitchcock. You are watching Harkins Theaters Behind the Screens, and this is a very special Behind the Screens. A, we're in the freezer. If you haven't been to the freezer, you have to check it out, harkins.com. It's here at Camel View. But B, more importantly, we've probably got one of the biggest stars around in town, Eddie Harkins. I think he's done with the popcorn. I'm not quite sure. Eugenio Derbez, one of the stars of Dora and the Lost City of Gold. Mm. Oh, you've even got a loyalty cup.
Mm-hmm. I got a loyalty cup and the popcorn. The popcorn is amazing.
Yeah. And oh, he's not God. Just saying that.
I can't stop eating it, so I still have popcorn in my mouth.
You know the jungle. It's a part of you. But exploring is not a game. And you don't look before you leap.
First of all, welcome. This is so fantastic that you're here at a Harkins. I know you travel all over the country to talk about movies. This one's kind of special. You've got kids. I know a few of them are grown. But you've got kids, and they were into Dora the Explorer.
Absolutely. And my baby, I have a five-year-old baby girl. And she's so excited about watching the movie. And but you know, this is a different version. So don't be scared. If you're a dad, don't be scared of that you're gonna get bored watching the film, because it has humor for everyone.
All those that seek Parapata shall surely perish.
It's a different version. The cartoon is probably the storyline is kind of simple, but the movie is completely different. The movie is exciting. It has a lot of adventure. It has heart, a lot of humor. You're gonna enjoy the film with your teenagers, your toddlers, your grandmother, your grandfather. You can bring the entire family, and everyone's gonna have fun.
There's no need to overreact.
You provide a lot of that humor. There are some very funny scenes with you in it. Did you shoot this in the jungle, but in Australia?
In Australia. We shot this like for almost 5 months in Australia, in the real, real jungle. So probably 90% of what you watch on screen is real. Mm-hmm. There's no green screen at all. Well, a few for some scenes, but we were there for 5 months. It was scary because there are a lot of poisonous spiders
and snakes. Right.
Of course. So it was really, really scary.
Run for your lives!
You're a city guy. You're born in Mexico City. Yeah. You now live in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
How would you fare in the jungle? How long would you last in the jungle? You just took your family on a camping trip. Are you the one who's needing the help?
Well, after being in Australia, I think probably, I don't know, at least like 6-7 hours.
And then you're out of there.
I'm out of there.
Like, where's the Harkins popcorn in my loyalty cup?
Exactly,
right?
Exactly. You know? No, it's really hard. The jungle is really, really hard. It's scary.
You know what else was hard, though? You made that move. I mean, you basically came to America. You didn't speak a ton of English. You were trying to make it here.
I'm still learning it, by the way.
Well, your English is a lot better than my Spanish. But it's a big leap to do that. And in this movie, she also kind of leaves her family and ends up in the city and ends up in high school.
Exactly.
What was the toughest thing for you when you were making that change and that move?
First of all, I felt inside me that I should do this. Everyone was telling me, you're crazy, you're not a kid anymore, you have everything here in Mexico, don't leave. I had a career, my production office for 25 years, and all of a sudden I said, I know this is the moment, I can feel it. So if nothing happens, I can come back, but I have to go for my dreams. And I took a leap of faith and I came to the US, and things are going great. Of course, a lot of work,
right.
And you have to be kind of smart making decisions, and especially knowing who to work with. That's very important, to know someone here in the US and that can guide me in this new industry. But I think I'm doing well.
I think we're safe for now.
I've watched a lot of your interviews. You are still like a kid in a candy store. You are very much a child.
Very,
heart.
Yeah.
And so is Dora. And I love some of the scenes. She's so innocent. She says hi to everybody at the airport. She just wants everybody to be friends. And in this day and age, when, you know, the minute somebody approaches us, we're immediately assuming it's not going to be pretty.
Exactly. The beginning of the movie is amazing. It's really funny, because it's the first time that Dora comes out of the jungle in 18 years. So that scene when she's at the airport for the first time and she's introducing herself to every single one.
It made me want to hug somebody at the airport the next time I go there.
Exactly.
But how do you keep that kind of childlike love of life and of what you're doing?
Well, you need to do what you love. Every single day, no matter what. Probably if you're working at a place where you're not happy, quit. Really, doesn't matter if you're getting a big check every month, don't do it. You have to be happy. You have to love what you want. Since I was a kid, everyone was always bullying me that you act like a baby. You're like a kid, but it's good to be a kid. It's not bad. So play with your kids. Get wet when it's raining, do kiddish stuff. Don't be afraid of being a kid. That's really important for your soul, especially.
I know this is based on Dora the Explorer. Last question, if you were to go explore a place, some place you've always wanted to go explore and you haven't yet, where is that place for you?
Oh my God, interesting. I love nature very much. So I would go to probably I haven't been in Yellowstone ever, and I'm very curious about it, so probably there.
Or the Grand Canyon state where Harkins is
based.
Of
course! That's what I was
bringing it back to Harkins.
Grand Canyon, yeah.
Okay. Well, we appreciate you joining us. If you want to see more, because we're doing a whole Q&A with Eugenio, and we'll also talk to some of the other cast members, just go to the extended version of my cast interviews on Harkins.com, and that's also where you can get tickets to Dora and the Lost City of Gold.
Yeah, don't miss it. August 9th in theaters.
You want more popcorn? You can go.
Yes, please.
You can go. All right. Thanks, Eugenio.
Are we done?
We're done. You can go eat.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're welcome.